Greetings, Guardians. My name is Byfe here. Welcome back to Extra Lore. This time I wanted to go over what we know about the Devil Splicers and their effect on the politics of the House of Devils. Sounds a little boring at first, but it's important because whilst it shows a mastery of bioengineering that can be achieved by the Splicers, it also shows how fragmented the Fallen Presence has become in Sol generally. Once mighty houses spanned the system with outposts and spies in many places, but now they have crumbled to fractured husks of their former selves, with infighting and rebellion. In particular, I wanted to explore one of the more fascinating possibilities. Could there have been a civil war between the Fallen within the House of Devils, running up to the beginning of Rise of Iron? To understand more, we need to know a little bit of history. Time has not been kind to the Devils. Their Kells have been murdered by the Guardian Orders many times. Razor Lazir and Saint 14 each had their turns ending one of these leaders. The Fallen assaults on the city have always ended in catastrophe, and the Devils have been the one to most consistently bear the brunt of these failures. And even in our infancy as Guardians, we were able to bring enough malice and light to end the ascension of one of their rising Archons, Rixis. And since then, we've done nothing more than assail them further. The destruction of their Archon was swiftly followed by the destruction of their prime servitor. The devastation of their house was followed by the disruption of their efforts to crack Rasputin. Time has not been kind as the Devil's techno-religious leadership was brought to its knees. And with this, there was weakness in the house. Weakness that could be smelt within their own ranks, like fear permeating into the dark reaches of their minds. But some who smell fear can sense the opportunity that comes with it. Between this optimism and a certain breed of madness lie the Devil Splicers. Splicers have supposedly always existed within the background of each Fallen House, as tinkerers, bioengineers, body hackers, and scientists. Their goal is simple: advance the evolution of the Fallen race. For the Devils, this search was normally one that simply allowed them to unravel further truths lying between synthetic and organic advancements. For a long time, they bowed their heads to the techno-religious leadership of the Devils, much like the Splicers in any house. But the circumstances surrounding the weakness of the religious leadership in the house, and the more recent discovery of Siva, changed all this. The Archons saw Siva as a holy relic, to be worshipped and deified. But it's suddenly clear that the House of Devils sect of Splicers was not so convinced of this assessment. They saw Siva as something greater. Siva could regenerate that which was lost, construct weapons of unthinkable power, melded from flesh and steel. Siva was not a god. No, it was a god-maker. Not to be worshipped, but to be used. The details are not entirely clear, but it appears that the very discovery of Siva tore a rift in the House of Devils, a rift that might still be present to this day. The events of such a schism's occurrence are clouded in mystery, and as such, much of what I will state is naught more than theory and conjecture. It's possible that this rift of ideals could have been solved peacefully, but such phrase in leadership for Fallen Houses often ends in violence. When the Kell of the House of Wolves was killed by the Queen in the Great Scatter, his top three barons went to war to control the house. Skolas eventually emerged victorious, but not without killing many of his fellow wolves in the process. It is perhaps not too far-fetched to believe that this philosophical disagreement between the Devils was not settled simply by debate. After all, as Varix would say, for faith, the Fallen will do anything. And Siva was more than an object of mere faith. For some Fallen, it would represent everything. With the denial of the Traveler and the destruction of Sepex Prime, the techno-religious leaders of the Devils needed something to rally their forces around. Siva, a new deity, could be that rallying cry. But for the Splicers, detainted with their melding of flesh and machine, to claim so boldly that they would be demigods, such a claim to power would be an affront to the House's leadership, to say the least. And so it is perhaps logical to assume that the House began to rip itself apart. Maybe the Devil's civil war would have been the end of the House entirely, were it not for a few key moves by the Splicers, at least. The chronology of these events is not clear, nor is the current disposition of the Devil's rank-and-file soldiers to the newly rising Splicers. But we do know that if there was conflict, a few key moments would have defined it. The Devil's Splicers perhaps reached out to one of the Archons, offering to show them the true power of the Siva, leading to the creation of the Archon Prime, Axis. It's not entirely clear why the Devil's Splicers would have done this, perhaps simply so that they could quell the battle quickly and end any rebellious forces within the rank and file. Maybe they realized that they were outnumbered, and the only way to do this was to take advantage of one of the techno-religious leaders. Or perhaps one of the leaders themselves called for a stop to the fighting, to investigate what this new deification could offer him. If this is the case, then maybe this is the reason for the conversion of one of their leaders into a deity. That should have been enough, but clearly it was not. Shiro 4 seems to indicate in his speech while we assault the Devil's Lair that not all the Devil's rank and file were entirely convinced by the ascension of Axis. The Prime Servitor had to be resurrected as well, to command faith through material means. Even a Siva-infused Servitor is able to feed ether to its followers, though it is synthetic and unusual to them. And with Siva in their hands, the Splicers would use Sepex as a means to do just this, demanding the fealty of all the Devils. But what's more, they needed a common enemy, and not simply gods to rally around. We see proof of this diversionary tactic simply by looking at the quest we undertake to reforge the Yalahorn. After exploring Faisal Crux's workshop on Bannerfall, a fallen vanguard strikes out with the intent of destroying the tower and breaching the wall. We later discover that this was no singular assault. It was the harbinger of a greater force marshalling on the edge of the city's limits, poised to strike like in the days of old. It might seem like the most logical explanation is that the Splicers wished to remind the other Devils of who their greater enemy was. But by doing this, they could have accomplished something more. If the demigods of the Splicer forces could achieve victory against the risen guardians of the Traveler, would this not act as their final proof of their authority? To defeat the forces of their prior god as mere demigods? Surely this showed the power of the Splicer's command, and of Siva itself. Would this not prove that Siva indeed was something to be immersed in, and revered above even the Traveler? Would defeating a god not accomplish the Splicer's plan of becoming gods themselves? There are many questions that we could ask, but thankfully, we do not need to ask them. Regardless of whether the Devil Splicers sent out forces to attack the city as part of a greater strategy of influencing their counterparts, or as a more simple matter of revenge, they were not prepared for the Guardians. Once again, history repeated itself, and the Devils were crushed. The Splicers' High Command was dealt a great blow that day. The Devils were made weak, but were by no means defeated. The Splicers' greatest creation, Axis, was still safe within the Perfection Complex. Here they would bide their time and plot their next move. Finally, it was decided. A signal was to be sent to all fallen houses. It demanded their attention and called to them, letting them know that they had found the means to ascension, inviting them to the Perfection Complex and offering them a place amongst their new pantheon of gods. But this would not come to pass. The devils would not be allowed to gain any more ground, because you were there to stop them. You raided their fortress and destroyed their high command, crippling them even to their new god, the Archon Prime. And when you faced the wrath of the machine, you were not bent or broken, but instead, you prevailed. I hope you guys found this video interesting. Tell me your thoughts in the comments section down below. Do you believe, like I do, that there may indeed have been a civil war within the House of Devils just before Rise of Iron began? And if so, wouldn't you like to know more about it? It's a subject that's only hinted at in the Grimoire, but something that's well worth making an entire video about. Also note that, with lore wrapping itself up more commonly nowadays, I wanted to go ahead and do more of a back catalogue of videos. Things that you guys have always requested, which are more general topics, but that I have always been more hesitant to cover. We'll be going over subjects such as Thorn and the Last Word eventually, but I wanted to start out with some more generic topics. Things such as the old raids like Crota's End and the Vault of Glass, talking about Osiris and Toland, and more generally, about the forces in the world of Destiny. But in the meantime, if you enjoyed this video, please go ahead and leave a like. And on top of this, if you wanted to know more about the lore of Destiny, let me know what you want to know about in the comments section down below. But in the meantime, my name has been, my name is Bife. Hurudasia Arastra. I'll see you, Starside.